There's this question that's been lingering in my mind for a minute. Why do we come here? No, it's not a rhetorical question. Why do we come here? Do you come to seek salvation? Good. But really, like, you ever think about why God put you on this earth? It's a simple but not so simple answer. Bear with me. You have to understand that God knew who you were before you were even born, that He spoke you into existence. Think about it this way. He knew you before you were even born, before the foundations of the earth. When we read the Bible, the human mind can't really comprehend it, and I thank God for our pastors. No, for real, our pastors are able to break down the word of God and teach us about the gospel. Gospel. What does that mean? Hey Siri, what does gospel mean?
Here's what I found on the web for what is fossil and beans.
Okay, gotta do it myself.
Don't let's start in 10 minutes. You coming? Fist bump emoji.
Oh, shoot.
Pastors are coming to me all the time. How do you have so many young people in your church? I said, simple. Because we told them, you can't be loud, you can't shout in church. So they took their shout to the nightclub. They took their shout to the festival. But the devil is a liar. We're telling a generation, don't take your shout out. Bring your shout back to the house of God.
So why do we come here? See, the answer is simple. You are right where you need to be. It's not only lifestyle of freedom, but it's family groups too. Did you think Jesus died on that cross for just one generation? No, it was for everyone born before and after him. Pastor Jason said something that will always stick with me. Tell me who your five closest friends are, and I'll tell you where you're headed. The last words that Jesus said on this earth were to save souls and make disciples. Freedom we receive, freedom we give. This is the lifestyle of freedom.